Hey friends, when it comes to integrating hybrid data at enterprise scale, Azure Data Factory is what you need. We're going to learn about some exciting new capabilities, change data capture, and managed airflow. Mark and Abhishek are here to show me what's new today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. Today I've got Mark Kromer from the Azure Data Factory team, and he's got his friend Abhishek, who's going to share with me some new capabilities. How are you, sir?
I'm good, Scott. Thanks for having us on.
So you brought me some demos of two different features. You're going to show me one first, and I think that would be change data capture, or what we call CDC.
That's right. So within Data Factory, as I know that you're well aware already, we've been a leader in the data integration and ETL space for a long time. And a really exciting thing that we've invested in the past, I would say, 12 months, and a recent announcement that we had to really take this to the next level, is allowing our users, our customers, to be able to bring in data from many different data sources in a really, really fast and efficient way. And we do that through what's known as change data capture, CDC. The announcement that we're making and that we're talking about today is, you can see what I want to do is I want to quick show you on my screen. Yeah, thanks for that. If you look at my screen, you'll see now change data capture is actually a top level resource within Data Factory. So we've had a lot of love and care and feeding around pipelines and data flows and Power Query within ADF over the years. What we've done is we've taken the change data capture features that have been present in the product to be able to get just the latest rows and data that have changed from your sources, taken that to the next level and made it a top level feature now within Data Factory. So it's really super simple to get started. You don't need to build a pipeline. You don't need to graph out a data flow. You just, you can see on my screen what I'm doing with a change data capture here. I'm just picking a source and a target. After you've configured everything, you're going to click a start button. In fact, what I'll do is, since we're here, let me just click stop on this, and I'll actually stop this one from running. And you have a button, so you don't need to make a trigger. You don't need to set a schedule. You just say, I want my data from here to go to here. In this case, I'm looking at a SQL Server table, which is called sales product. And I'm putting that data into a Delta format. So I'm creating a Delta lake out of that. And once I click the start button, Data Factory will just execute this continuously. It's as simple as that.
Interesting. And by bringing it up to the front, you are elevating it. Like, change data capture is as important as data flows, as important as templates, as important in data sets, because you're going to be using it all the time as you work your way through Azure Data Factory.
Yeah, precisely. Exactly. So let me give you an example of what that means. So if you look at what we've had for CDC previously within Data Factory, I'll show you an example of this. So here's an example of a CDC-enabled data flow. Now, this is a very simple one. I just have some source data and then some target data. And of course, I can apply my transformations in between those two things. But on my source, if I were to run this from a pipeline, without using change data capture, this would read from my movies file or folder every hour, 15 minutes, whatever I set the schedule for. But all the data that's in there will be read every time. What we did probably around this time last year was we enabled a feature called change data capture within data flows. So you see, this is just a checkbox. We always in Data Factory aim to make your data engineering job super simple, right? So we enable this checkbox. And now look at these different options you can have. You can say, give me just the incremental changes, or give me everything that's already there, and then subsequently incrementals. What's real nice about this, Scott, is that Data Factory natively takes care of all that for you. We maintain the checkpoints, the watermarks. You don't need to build any metadata-driven pipelines. You don't need to manage any that yourself. Just check the box and rest assured that we've got you covered for that. So that was easy, right? Customers love that. But what happens is you have to know how to build a data flow. You have to graph a pipeline, right? So the pipelines look like these at these artifacts here. So these are going to be really simple ones. But in this case, I have a data flow. Maybe I'm also copying some data. And you got to build a workflow for that. If all you want to do is get your latest changes and put them into a data store, now we have this capability. This is what we're talking about, and this is what we just announced. All you have to do is say, I want a new change data capture. So you say new, it's called a mapping, a new mapping. you will give it a name, pick your source. A real common change data capture source is going to be your SQL database, right? And what connection do you want to use? After that, you're going to get a list of all the tables that have either CDC enabled or a column that you can use to get the latest changes. So you don't have to have the native SQL CDC enabled. These are native SQL CDC enabled tables here, but you could pick a table that has a date time column or a numeric column in it, and we can use that for you. Simple as that.
So it's smart enough to give me a CDC like experience, even if I haven't explicitly turned it on in SQL.
That's right. That's right. And a lot of this has been a long time thing with SQL Server. Right? A lot of DBAs don't necessarily want to turn on CDC natively on their tables. And so that's fine. We will allow you to use columns to do a watermark style.
Interesting. And you're doing this in such a way that you're going to take pressure off my database. Certainly, we don't want to be beating on it every 5 minutes. You're doing whatever the appropriate and right thing to do is to enable both that database to do its regular day job, but also support these kind of data factory chain sets.
Exactly. So that's a great setup. So what I'm going to do is let me finish this right here. This is all you have to do for a configuration. And I'll call this demo for Scott. And what we do next is when you're done with all this, what's really cool is you don't need to set any kind of triggers or pipelines. You just set your latency. So in terms of your comment about creating saturation on that database source, you say, how often do you want to check for those changes? And we will only get the things that change during that time. Two things I want to finish up this demo with is we are releasing within the next couple of weeks this capability here called less than 1 minute latency. This is super exciting and super new for Data Factory fans. Everything within Data Factory over the past, 8 years that we've been in market is that it's always batch oriented. With this CDC feature, it is continuous. So you can set a latency to say wake up every 15 minutes and run, but you could also say now less than 1 minute. So it's essentially continuous. And then a little bit after that is when we're going to enable this feature up top, which you will see grayed out for now, which is real time. And that's, we'll come back with you, Scott, and talk to you about that when that lands. But that's Kafka and Event Hub sources.
That's cool. So, I love that you actually are showing us those icons. You've grayed them out, but you say that they're coming soon. Now, if people want to see change data capture in their existing Data Factory pages, they just click preview experience at the top there, and they can start playing with it right away.
Yeah, it's actually already enabled, but it does have the preview tag, like you said. We're just calling that out just so you're aware that it's public preview. It's fully supported, but there are plenty of organizations that we work with that say that, well, I want to wait for it to become generally available before I use it in a production mode. That's fine. It's fully supported. We will support you and make you successful in it. And yeah, real excited for customers to begin using that.
I understand also that you brought a friend who wants to share managed Airflow and see how that works with Apache Airflow.
Yeah. So Abhishek, why don't you give us some insights into what we're doing with open source and Airflow?
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Thanks, Mark. Thanks, Scott. So let's talk about Apache Airflow and what it is and what we are coming up the new offering with. So Apache Airflow is an open source orchestration tool, and it kind of aligns very well with Data Factory, which is an orchestration tool for data processes. The value add that Airflow adds is it's pure Python. So Python developers love Apache Airflow. And then it has robust integrations. It integrates with a lot of different sources, a lot of different connectors, cross-cloud, multi-cloud, all of those. And then it's open source. So there's a huge amount of community contributions into it. On the right-hand side, you see a bunch of providers which are already available. So you can quickly get started writing your code and leveraging all those community providers to kind of connect to those different sources. Now with that, I'll quickly run through where we are right now. So what we are doing is we are offering now a managed Airflow as a service, Apache Airflow as a service, and we are terming that as managed Airflow. And it's super simple to get started with. So earlier, as customers were setting up Airflow on Azure, they would kind of start with Azure VM, setting up Azure VM, and then going ahead, installing the Airflow runtime, the software on it, Python runtime, all the different runtimes. It's going to take a long time to kind of set that up, and then you have to manage that. Now, what we did is we simplified that process, and you can simply click on this UI in the ADF, in the Manage Hub, under the Airflow tab. You can click on the plus sign and quickly create the Airflow instance. A few important things here. since we made it cloud native, we made sure we integrated with Active Directory as well, so that with the same open source software, you get the promise, the security promises on Azure, like integrated with AD, the audit logs, the metrics and Azure monitoring metrics and stuff. All those things, you get that for free on top of it. And so you can choose the size of the cluster that you want for this Airflow. And then you can add extra nodes. These extra nodes are for the workers, the additional workers that you would use for processing your data. And you simply hit on this create button. And that's how simple it is. It's gonna take a few minutes, maybe about 10 to 20 minutes. And then you will have your environment up and ready to get started with. And then the next step, which I will run you through, is I have an environment which I've already created. So I will probably use that. And I'll use the one with Airflow with SSO. And I'm going to quickly launch it. And we kept the whole Airflow promise together. This is the same Airflow UI that you would get when you're using it on-prem. And you see there's no DAGs. DAGs is basically equivalent to the data pipelines that you would be building here. And it's empty. There's nothing. So let's go ahead and get some DAGs up and running. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to import a few DAGs, and I'm going to say import files. Choose a connection to a blob storage. So you got to put your files onto a blob storage, and we will connect to that. And what we expect here is you would have your DAGs in a folder called DAGs. That's the typical pattern on Airflow, is you would put all your code files in a DAGs folder, and we would import all these files from DAGs. So this is how simple it is to get started with creating the new environment and then uploading your existing Airflow files and clicking on this import button. It's going to take a few seconds, and it's going to import these files into the Airflow environment, and it says it's successfully imported. Now we're going to move back to our Airflow UI, hit the refresh button right here, and you would see that you have both these two DAGs. And just to kind of give you a quick overview, these two DAGs, you know, one of the DAGs is basically calling an existing data factory pipeline for moving high performance data. And then other pipelines basically calling event processing pipeline. Again, this is using data flows. And it kind of brings together, you know, into a single pipeline in Airflow, which orchestrates that. And you would be able to see these Airflow pipelines and the status of that. It's right now running. And it's going to take a few seconds, and that's going to be done. So this is right. how simple it was.
Hopefully our audience is familiar with Apache Airflow, but if they're not, it is worth pointing out, just as an interesting point of note for folks that may not be deeply familiar with this, that the word that you're saying is not tag with a T, it's DAG with a D, a directed acyclic graph, right? And these are those pieces, those atomic pieces that build up the molecules of which the workflow is expressed. They're the tasks that get built up into relationships. And this is just really, like you can see, you just switched into the actual Airflow dashboard, right? This is not like a custom fork, is it? It's the real open source Apache Airflow.
That is right.
That's very cool. And I noticed also, I just saw the version number go by 2.43. I assume you can pick versions. I know 2.5 just came out a couple months ago. I don't have to worry about that anymore like I would if I had to make a virtual machine.
Absolutely. So that's one of the key offerings, that you will always be updated. So we will keep you updated on the latest versions. Of course, not the major versions, but the minor versions will come out, roll out as a transparent update to users.
Fantastic. That's so cool. Yeah, being able to do, and this is the thing, right? This is the whole point of the cloud, is I don't want to have to worry about the care and feeding of the Airflow instance. I just want to use it. And Airflow is a very dynamic Python-driven world. And I really want to focus on that part of it and not the keeping it running part.
Absolutely.
Very cool. So is this in preview or is this available right now? Can people use this immediately?
Yeah, they can use it immediately. This is in public preview right now. We just announced it. And then it's ready for users to kind of use it in under public preview.
Very cool. Well, let's bring Mark back in. This is a very exciting time for Azure Data Factory. You all are just boom, 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 bringing out the features.
Yeah,
Yeah, I think there's a wide range of things, right? That we covered two different, very different features within Data Factory, but they expand the scope of Data Factory, right? We have just so many use cases that our customers just want to be able to do in Azure, and we just decide to bring that to them through these ways. And, you know, from the open source adoption of Airflow to the ability to get your data in through a pipeline using change data capture or through the change data capture resource, you know, we feel like we got you covered with Data Factory.
That's a really great point. Yes, it is expanding the Azure Data Factory cinematic universe, whether it be on the front end when we're capturing the data or how we see that data move through. The tools are available and folks can start playing with these immediately. Thank you both for hanging out with us today.
Thanks, Scott. It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
I am learning all about change data capture in Azure Data Factory, as well as managed Airflow in Azure Data Factory. You can check them out today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.